A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And today I am dealing with Lecture 2 of Unit 5, that is Maxwell's Equations. So under the Maxwell's Equation, I am covering Maxwell's Equations in point form, Maxwell's equations in integral form, and some numericals, examples and solutions related to Maxwell's equations. So this is the Maxwell's equation I have listed in point form as well as in integral form. So the first column is in point form. We will call this as differential form also. And second column represents the integral form. And the third column represents the significance. Now let us see the first one, that is del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T. So according to Maxwell's equation in static field, we had an equation as del cross E is equal to 0. But in time varying field, we have done the corrections for this Maxwell's equation using a Faraday's law as del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T. So the significance of this is in Faraday's law, and the integral form of this equation is integration for a closed path E dot dl is equal to minus integration, that is surface integration of dou b divided by dou t dot ds. So this is the first Maxwell's equation in point form as well as in differential form as well as in integral form. So second equation, let us say that is del cross h is equal to j plus dou d by dou t. So actually we have an equation as a del cross H equal to J alone. But if we consider the time varying field, then del cross H becomes del cross H is equal to J plus dou D divided by dou T. That is nothing but JD. We have already defined it as displacement current density. So del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. And this is the corrections what we have made for Ampere's circuital law, which is del cross H is equal to J alone. So in time varying field, the Ampere circuital law, del cross H becomes, H equal to J becomes del cross H is equal to J plus dou D divided by dou T. So in integral form, if we write, then integration of H dot dl is equal to I in case of Ampere's law, but time varying field if we consider, then it becomes I plus integration, surface integration of dou d divided by dou t dot ds. So this significance of the second equation is Ampere circuital law. So the first two equations are the equations we have considered or we have derived in the time varying fields. That is del cross E is equal to minus dou b by dou t and del cross H is equal to J plus dou d divided by dou t. Now the remaining two Maxwell's equations are, the first one is del dot D is equal to rho v, that is the Gauss law, and we will write in integral form as d dot ds is equal to integration of rho v dv. So d dot ds is equal to rho v dv. Similarly, del dot b is equal to 0, the integral form is b dot ds is equal to 0, that is in case of magnetic field. So this is in case of electric field, and this is in case of magnetic field. So these are the four Maxwell's equation, both in differential or point form as well as in integral form. Now based on these Maxwell's equations, now we are going to deal with some of the numerical examples. Let us start with first one. If the magnetic field H is equal to 3x cos beta plus 6y sin alpha in AZ direction, find current density J if fields are invariant with time. So In this question, they are asking us to calculate the value of current density J, and they have given the value of H, and the special stress they have given is the fields are totally invariant with respect to time variable. So whenever they say invariant with respect to time, that means they are not at all varying with respect to time. Then del cross H, whatever we have listed, del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. So the term dou D by dou T will become zero, because the given value of H is not varying with respect to time. Looking at the H also, we will come to know there is no variable of time T. So it is only with respect to X and Y in a Z direction. Hence, the Maxwell's equation, we will use it as del cross H is equal to J, because it is not in time varying field. Now substitute the value of H and calculate the cross product to find out the value of J. Now this is, H is in only AZ direction. Hence AX, AY, AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z, and 0, 0, 3X cos beta plus 6Y sin alpha. Now AX as it is into D dou by dou Y of this term, that is 3X cos beta plus 6Y sin alpha, that is AX component, minus dou by dou Z into 0 is 0. Then minus AY into dou by dou X of this term, that is minus dou by dou X of 3X cos beta plus 6Y sin alpha in AY direction, minus AY. And dou by dou z of 0 is 0. And if I take constant az column, then dou by dou x of 0 minus dou y of 0. Both the terms are 0. Now let us simplify this term. So dou by dou y of, that is 6y sin alpha, and the term 3x cos beta will become, constant, that is dou by dou y of x, the term x will become 0. So only the differentiation is possible with respect to y, that is dou by dou y of y is equal to 1. Hence we will get this term as 6 sine alpha in ax direction minus. Similarly, dou by dou x of x will retain, that is 3 cos beta. Derivative of x with respect to x is 1, and derivative of x with respect to y, it becomes 0. Second term will become 0. So the first term will become 3 cos beta in AY direction. So this is the current density J what we have calculated, and we will write it as ampere per meter square. So wherein means H is not varying with respect to time. Hence del cross H is equal to J only we have considered, and we have calculated the value of J using the formula. Now let us consider the next one, next example. In this, do the fields E is equal to EM sin X sin T AY and H is equal to EM by mu naught cos X cos T AZ satisfy Maxwell's equations. So will this satisfies Maxwell's equations that we have to calculate. So looking at the equation of E and H, we can clearly say that both E and H are varying with respect to time, because we have a term sin t as well as a cos t. There is a sin t and there is a cos t. So these two terms are varying with respect to time. Hence, we have to use the Maxwell's equations in time varying field, one with respect to E and one with respect to H. That is, with respect to E means we have to use the Maxwell's equation which we have derived from Faraday's law, that is del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T. So let us do the first one, that is del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T. And we know that B is equal to mu into H, which is equal to mu naught mu r and let us, they have not specified any medium. Let us take it as mu is equal to mu naught alone by making mu r is equal to 1 for a free space. Then this equation, that is Maxwell's equation, becomes del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou h divided by dou t. I have defined the Maxwell's equation in terms of field intensities, that is del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou h by dou t, because in the numerical they have given both E as well as H. Now let us consider the left side, that is LHS, that is nothing but del cross E, and we will calculate the value of del cross E. AX, AY, AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z, EX, EY, EZ, and in the numerical they have given only AY component, that is EM sin X sin T. In AY component, EM sin X sin T. EM sin X sin T in AY direction, hence EM sin X sin T. That is in case of EY component. Now let us calculate the cross product. AX as it is, then dou y of 0 minus dou by dou z of em sin t sin x, plus ay component as it is, that is minus ay, this term into this term, 0, and dou by dou z of 0 is equal to 0 again. Then AZ as it is, then dou by dou X of this term minus dou by dou Z of 0, and then we will simplify this. So dou by dou z of this term, anyway this becomes 0 because there is no differentiation with respect to z. There is no z term. You have to consider only this part. So this becomes dou by dou x of em sin x sin t. Only this term will survive. So derivative of x is sin x is cos x. So this becomes em sin t cos x in az direction. Remaining all the term will become 0. So the del cross E value will become EM sin T cos X in AZ direction. Now we have done del cross E, that is left side. Now let us calculate right side, that is minus dou B by dou T, and B value is nothing but in terms of H we have to take, that is EM divided by mu naught cos X cos T AZ, and mu naught will get cancelled because this is minus mu naught into dou H by dou T. So RHS minus mu naught into dou H by dou T minus mu naught into dou by dou T of H, that is EM by mu naught into cos X cos T AZ in AZ direction, minus mu naught as it is, EM by mu naught is a constant. Now find the derivative with respect to T, wherein which cos X will behave as a constant. Derivative of cos T is sin T minus sin t, so minus with minus plus and mu naught will get cancelled, and this equation becomes em cos x sin t, that is em sin t cos x in az direction. So this is how we will prove that del cross E value is also em sin x sin t cos x, and RHS also em sin t cos x. Hence the given two fields, that is E as well as H, they will satisfy the Maxwell's equation. This is how we will do the numerical. Let us see the next one. Let me take the third example. Let us note down the question first. So given E is equal to E naught Z square e to the power minus t ax in free space. Determine if there exists a magnetic field such that both Faraday's law and Ampere circuit law are satisfied simultaneously. That means for the given value of E, both Faraday's law as well as Ampere's law are satisfying. Hence, we have to calculate the magnetic field which corresponds to the electric field given in free space. So since the given E, looking at the E, we can conclude that this is in time varying field because we have a term e to the power minus t. Hence we will use the Faraday's law in time varying field as del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou t, and the given value E is equal to E naught Z square e to the power minus t AX direction. Let us find out the left side, that is the cross product AX, AY, AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z, and AX component of E is E naught Z square e to the power minus t, and remaining two will be zero. So if I calculate the cross product AX as it is, then dou by dou Y of zero minus dou by dou Y dou Z of zero is zero, minus AY component of dou by dou X of zero is zero, minus dou by dou Z of E naught Z square minus T, that is zero minus dou by dou Z of E naught Z square minus T with minus AY will retain. Now see, for the third constant, that is AZ as it is, then dou by dou X of zero minus dou by dou Y of E naught Z square minus T. So again, this term will become zero. AX component is also zero. AZ component is also zero. So only AY component will survive because there is a term dou by dou Z of Z square. So minus with minus, we will make it as a plus. Then dou by dou Z of Z square is 2Z. Then E naught and E to the power minus T will behave as a constant into EAY. So this will be the term del cross E. So del cross E becomes 2Z E naught E to the power minus T AY component. Hence, according to the Faraday's law, del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. But we need to calculate the magnetic field. Now let us write this equation as B is equal to integration of del cross E with respect to dt. We have to integrate because derivative is with respect to dt. Hence B is equal to minus integration of del cross E with respect to dt. So del cross E, we have calculated del cross E as 2z E naught e to the power minus t into AY component, that is a dt, and minus sign as it is, we will keep it outside. Now we will integrate this with respect to t. So integration of e to the power minus t is minus of e to the power minus t. Integration we will get. So we will get this term as minus 2z e naught, which behave as a constant. And integration of e to the power minus t is minus e to the power minus t into AY component. Hence B value becomes minus with minus plus 2z e naught e to the power minus t AY component. Also we know that B is equal to mu into h. So in free space, let us consider mu r equal to 1. Hence mu is equal to mu naught. So B is equal to mu naught into H, and H is equal to B divided by mu naught, and B value is 2 E naught Z e to the power minus T AY divided by mu naught ampere per meter. That is the value of magnetic field intensity by using Faraday's law alone. But in the equation, they have given it obeys both Faraday's law as well as ampere circuit law. Now we have done with the Faraday's law, first one. Now let us consider the second one, that is according to Ampere's circuit law. It is del cross H is equal to J plus dou D divided by dou T. And we know that D is equal to epsilon times E. Hence, dou D divided by dou T can be written as epsilon times dou by dou T of D value. That is, dou D divided by dou T can be written as epsilon times dou by dou T of E, and E value in the numerical they have given E value as E naught Z square e to the power minus T AX component. Let us calculate dou D by dou T first. So let us differentiate this with respect to T. Differentiation of this term with respect to T becomes epsilon E naught Z square is a constant. Derivative of T with respect to that is e to the power minus T is minus e to the power minus T in AX component. It remains as it is. So I have calculated dou D by dou T. Now del cross H. Del cross H is equal to del cross. I have calculated the value of H as 2 E naught divided by mu naught Z into E to the power minus T AY component. That is EH. And let us calculate the value of del cross H. That is the left side. This term I have to calculate. The right side dou D by dou T I have calculated already. Now let us, using the value of H from the Faraday's law, we will calculate the value of del cross H. So that is AX, AY, AZ, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y, dou by dou Z. And this is in AY component. Hence we will substitute 0, 0. And in AY component, 2 E naught divided by mu naught Z e to the power minus T. That is 2 E naught divided by mu naught Z into e to the power minus T. Now let us simplify this. AX as it is. This into this, that is dou by dou Y of 0 is 0 minus dou by dou Z of 2 E naught divided by mu naught Z into e to the power minus T. I will retain into AX component. Then with minus AY component, dou by dou X of 0, dou by dou Z of 0, it is 0. 0, second term. Then the last term, AZ into, that is dou by dou X of this term, minus dou by dou Y of 0 is 0. So again, if you see, dou by dou X of this term is 0, because it behaves as a constant, there is no term containing X. And dou by dou z will survive because there is a term containing z. So let us differentiate this with respect to z. That is dou by dou z of z will become 1, constant 1. Hence this becomes minus 2 e naught divided by mu naught into e to the power minus t ax component. Remaining are 0, 0. So del cross h becomes minus 2 E naught divided by mu naught into e to the power minus T AX. So using the Maxwell's equation for ampere circuit law, it is del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T, and I have taken it as a free space, hence the current density J becomes 0. It becomes only del cross H equal to dou D by dou T. And I have calculated dou D by dou T as this value, and del cross H also I have calculated. Hence, I will write del cross H is equal to dou D by dou T alone, and del cross H is minus 2 E naught divided by mu naught e to the power minus T AX. Then dou D by dou T, that is minus epsilon naught Z square E naught e to the power minus T AX. Minus epsilon naught Z square E naught e to the power minus T AX. Hence, both are AX component. So you can equate these two to calculate the value of z. So here we can equate this, that is we can equate the component of ax and we can calculate the value of z square, that is e to the power minus t will get cancelled, e naught will get cancelled, minus with minus will become plus, that is epsilon naught will become the denominator, hence z square is equal to 1 divided by epsilon naught mu naught, or else z is equal to 1 divided by root of mu naught into epsilon naught. So this 2 is there, so it becomes under root 2. So root 2 divided by under root of mu naught into epsilon naught. Substitute the value of mu naught and epsilon naught. Mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. And simplify this, we will get it as z is equal to 4.2397 into 10 to the power minus 8. Now the question is to determine the magnetic field. The question is to determine the magnetic field, that is EH, and EH equation is this. And in this equation of EH, I have calculated the value of Z. And this becomes 2 E naught divided by mu naught into Z value, whatever I have calculated, into e to the power minus t EY component. So 2 E naught divided by mu naught into Z term, that is 4.2397 into 10 to the power 8 e to the power minus t AY. So mu naught value, I need to substitute it as 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 E naught e to the power minus t AY, and we'll get H is equal to 0.6747 into 10 to the power 15 E naught e to the power minus t AY component ampere per meter. So this is how we will calculate the value of EH using both Faraday's law as well as ampere circuit law in time varying field. Now let us take one more numerical, example 4, that is electric vector E of a wave in free space is given by Ex equal to 0, Ez equal to 0, and Ey is equal to A cos omega into t minus z by c, where c is velocity of light. Now using Maxwell's equation for free space, determine the expression for H. So that means they have given the expression for E and we need to determine the expression for H. Again, we have to use the Maxwell's equation. And this is in time varying field because we have cos omega of t minus z by t c is there. So it is time varying field. Hence we will use the Maxwell's equation in time varying field. That too, Faraday's law as del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou t. I will use the equation as del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou t. And I will substitute B is equal to mu into H, that is mu naught mu r into H, that is equal to mu naught into H because it is in free space. Hence mu r will become equal to 1. So this equation becomes del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou H divided by dou t. The equation becomes del cross E is equal to minus mu naught into dou H by dou T, and we need the value of H and they have given the value of E. Hence, let us find out del cross E first. That is AX, AY, AZ as it is, dou by dou X, dou by dou Y and dou by dou Z as it is. Then the given value of E is in Y component, EY, that is A cos omega minus omega into T minus Z divided by C. So I will write A cos omega t minus z by c as Ay component, Ax and Az are 0. Now let us find out del cross E first. That is Ax as it is, this into this, that is dou by dou y of 0 minus dou by dou z of A cos omega t minus z by c, that is the first term, into Ax. Then minus Ay into dou by dou x of 0 minus dou by dou z of 0, that is nothing but 0, plus Az into dou by dou x of A cos omega into t minus z by c minus dou by dou z of 0 is 0. So again, if you see here, this term, that is dou by dou x of A cos omega t minus z by c becomes 0 because it is a constant independent of the term x, and only the surviving term is this term. So that is dou by dou z of minus z. So that becomes minus 1. Hence minus with minus plus, derivative of dou by dou z of A cos omega into t minus z by c. So cos omega z by c, derivative of cos omega z by c is minus sine omega by c, A as it is, into sine omega of t minus z by c in Ax component. So del cross E value will become omega A by c into sine omega of t minus z by c in Ax component. Let us call this as equation A, because we need to calculate the value of H, and I have done the left hand side, that is a del cross E. Now let us calculate in the right hand side also, that is minus mu naught into dou H by dou T, and H is nothing but Hx Ax plus Hy Ay plus Hz Az. And here we need to consider only the Ax component. So I will retain only Ax component, that is minus mu naught into dou Hx by dou T is equal to the left hand side, that is del cross E. I will retain Ax alone because del cross E has only the Ax component. It doesn't have any Ay as well as Az component. Hence the minus mu naught into dou H by dou T, I will write it as minus mu naught into dou Hx by dou T, where H is taking only X component. And right side is omega A by C into sine omega of T minus Z divided by C. So let us simplify this. That is dou Hx by dou T is equal to, I will take minus mu naught to the right side. Now I want the value of Hx. Hence Hx is equal to minus mu naught A by omega C into integration. Minus mu naught A by omega C into integration of this sine omega of T minus Z by C with respect to T. That is sine omega of T minus Z by C with respect to DT. Now integration of sine is minus cos omega of T minus Z by C, and that I am to integrate with respect to T. That is with respect to T I have omega term, hence divided by omega. So omega and omega term will get cancelled. Minus with minus will become plus, and Hx will become A divided by mu naught into C cos omega of T minus Z divided by C. But we know that in free space, that is C is equal to velocity of light is equal to 1 divided by square root of mu naught into epsilon naught. Anyway, this equation we are going to derive, or we are going to find this in the next class, that is a uniform plane wave in free space. Or else you can substitute and check, that is 1 divided by square root of mu naught into epsilon naught. If you substitute, you will get the value as velocity of light. Hence, Hx, I will write it as A divided by mu naught into C cos of omega of T minus Z by C as Hx value as this A divided by mu naught into C, that is C value is this term. And I can put my Hx in the form as square root of mu naught divided epsilon naught by mu naught into A cos omega of T minus Z by C in Ax direction, that is ampere per meter. So you can represent the answer in any form. Starting from this, any form you can represent. Since they have, in the equation they have given the C is equal to velocity of light, hence I have represented H in the form of under root of mu naught divided by epsilon naught divided by mu ampere per meter. So this is how we will find the value of H in Maxwell's equation. Let us take one more example. Now in this, given H is equal to Hm e to the power j omega t plus beta z ax ampere per meter in free space, then find E. The term here is E. Find E, that is field intensity E, we need to calculate. Find E. So in the previous example, they were given E and we have calculated H. Now in this numerical, they have given the value of H and we will calculate the value of electric field intensity, that is capital E. Now again, looking at the equation of H, we can easily say that this is in time varying field. Omega t we have. Hence we will use the Maxwell equation as del cross H is equal to J plus dou d by dou t, because they have given the value of H. The previous cases and all we have done del cross E is equal to. Now here we have del cross H because they have given the value of H. So in free space, as usual, the conduction current density is zero. So J term will become zero and we will write del cross H is equal to just dou D divided by dou T. We will substitute the value of D as epsilon times E because I need the value of E. So hence this del cross H becomes del cross H is equal to epsilon times dou E divided by dou T. Now let us calculate del cross H, that is Ax component, Ay component as well as Az component. But the given value of H is having only Ax component. Hence, find out the cross product. And the given H has only Z component. There is no X as well as Y. Hence, wherever we have dou by dou Z term, that will remain. Wherever we have dou by dou Z term will remain. So dou by dou z of hy is zero because hy component as well as hz component is zero. The component is only in ax direction. And in this term, dou by dou z of hx. Hx is the in ay component, and in hx there is a z term. So only dou by dou z of ay, hx into ay term will remain. Even this term, that is dou hx by dou y in az direction, will become zero because h is varying with z only and not with y. Hence the final equation becomes del cross h in the left side is equal to dou hx divided by dou z into ay component, that is equal to epsilon times dou e divided by dou t according to Maxwell's equation. So let us substitute the value of hx, that is dou by dou z of hm e to the power j omega t plus beta z in ay component is equal to epsilon times dou e divided by dou t. I need the value of e here. So let us first differentiate with respect to dz. So if I differentiate this term with respect to dz, I have e to the power j beta z. So derivative of e to the power j beta z with respect to z is j beta into e to the power j beta z. Hence this term will become j beta into hm into e to the power j into omega t plus beta z as it is in ay component, this term. That is equal to epsilon times dou e divided by dou t. Now I will take epsilon to the left side, epsilon to the left side, and dou e divided by dou t if I want. If I want e from this, then I need to integrate this term with respect to t. So I will write it as j beta divided by epsilon constant as it is, hm also as it is. Then derivative of integration of e to the power j omega t plus beta z, that is dou by dou t of dou t. If I want e, I need to integrate this. Now integration of e to the power j omega t plus beta z with respect to t is nothing but e to the power j omega t can be integrated with respect to t as e to the power j omega t plus beta z divided by j omega, that is coefficient of t in ay component. Now e is equal to, let us simplify this, beta hm divided by epsilon omega, j value will get cancelled, and e to the power j omega t plus beta z into ay component, and this will be the final answer for electric field in volt per meter. So using Maxwell's equation, by giving the E we can calculate H, or by giving the value of H we can calculate E, or by using both E and H we can calculate the constants. So such a type of numericals we have done. Let us see one more example. That is, if E is equal to 125 into e to the power 3x minus kt in ay direction volt per meter in free space. Now we need to use the Maxwell's equation to find the value of k from Maxwell's equation. So we need to find the value of k as well as h. So we have determined k as well as h. Find the value of k and h. Here the term is h. We need to find the value of k and h from the Maxwell's equation. That is del cross E is equal to minus dou b divided by dou t. Hence write the Maxwell's equation, del cross E is equal to minus dou b by dou t. Then del cross E, E is having only ay component, hence ax, ay, az, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, 0, 0, and Ay component is 125 into e to the power 3x minus kt is equal to minus dou b divided by dou t. I need the value of h as well as the value of k. Now let us integrate this. Let us first find the cross product, then we will integrate and to find out the value of k. Now ax as it is, dou by dou y of 0, 0 minus dou by dou z of this term plus for ay component, this is 0, both are 0. And for az component, it is dou by dou x of 125 into e to the power 3x minus kt, that is az direction, minus dou by dou y of 0 is 0, equal to minus dou b divided by dou t. Now you can see in this, the first equation, that is dou by dou z of this term, dou by dou z of this term is 0 because there is no term z. So only this term will survive. That is dou by dou x of e to the power 3x. The derivative of e to the power 3x with respect to x is 3 into e to the power 3x. So 3 into 125 will become 375 into e to the power 3x minus kt into az as it is equal to minus dou b divided by. Now separate the terms and then integrate. Now I need b from this. So if I need b, I need to integrate this with respect to t. Hence integration of this with respect to t is 375 into e to the power 3x minus kt. So there is a term minus kt, and integration of this e to the power minus kt is e to the power minus kt divided by minus k. So hence minus with minus will become plus is equal to 375 divided by k into e to the power term as it is, that is e to the power 3x minus kt into az direction. This term will remain as it is. Now that is b. Now we will write b is equal to mu naught into h. Hence h is equal to b by mu naught is equal to b value. We have calculated b value divided by mu naught, that is 375 divided by k into mu naught is into e to the power 3x minus kt in az direction. Now from the Maxwell's equation based on Ampere circuit law, it is del cross H is equal to dou D by dou T, that is equal to dou by dou T of D is nothing but epsilon times E. J value is 0. So del cross H is equal to dou D by dou T in free space. Current density J value, we have taken it as 0. Hence, del cross H. So this is the value of H. I will find out del cross H. And H is having only az component. Hence, ax, ay, az, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, 0, 0, and az component is 375 by k into mu naught into e to the power 3x minus kt is equal to epsilon times dou e divided by dou t. Now again, I will find out the cross product. Ax as it is, dy, dy of this is 0. Minus dou by dou z of this is 0, minus ay of dou by minus ay of dou by dou x of this term, minus ay of dou by dou x of this term, minus dou by dou z of 0 is 0, and az as it is, these two terms are 0, hence 0. So I have only dou by dou x of this term is equal to epsilon times dou e divided by dou t. Now differentiate this equation with respect to x. Then 375 divided by k into mu naught into derivative of this with respect to x, we have to do that is e to the power 3x. Derivative is 3 into e to the power 3x minus kt ay is equal to epsilon times dou by dou t of e. Hence, dou by dou t of e is equal to, I will take epsilon to this side. Hence, this 3 into 375 will become minus 1125 divided by k into mu naught into epsilon naught into e to the power 3x minus kt in a y direction. Now, if I want e, then I need to integrate with respect to t. Then, if I integrate with respect to t, this equation, I have e to the power minus kt. Integration with respect to t is e to the power minus kt divided by minus k. That is, minus into minus will become plus, and 1 divided by k into k will become k square. That is, e value will become 1125 divided by k square into mu naught into epsilon naught into e to the power 3x minus kt ay direction volt per meter. Now, in the given equation of E, that is in the question, they have given the expression of E. Expression of E is 125 into e to the power my 3x minus kt in ay direction. So, if I compare this equation with the determined equation E, this is also in AY component, I will get 1125 divided by k square mu naught epsilon naught is equal to 125. That is comparing with original expression. So, here k square is equal to 1125 by 125 into mu naught into epsilon naught. Substitute the value of mu naught and epsilon naught. And then you can find the value of k, which is nothing but a constant. So h value you have already calculated, e value also calculated, and here I have calculated the value of a known value, that is constant value k. So this is one more type of the numerical that I have done, that is by giving the expression of e using the Maxwell's equation, we can identify the unknown term which is there in the given expression. So, along with determining the value of E as well as H in time varying field. Now, based on these type of numericals, we have some quick quiz questions. That is the first one. Maxwell's equation derived from Faraday's law. Which is Maxwell's equation derived from Faraday's law? Is it del dot J is equal to minus dou rho v by dou t, del cross E equal to minus dou v by dou t, or del cross H is equal to J plus dou d by dou t? Which is the Maxwell's equation which is derived from Faraday's law? Yes, it is option B, that is del cross E is equal to minus dou v divided by. Now, which is the Maxwell's equation derived from Gauss law for magnetic field? Is it del dot B equal to 0, del cross H equal to J plus dou D by dou T, or is it del dot D is equal to rho? Yes, option is A, that is del dot B is equal to 0. This is also Maxwell's equation for Gauss law only, but it is for electric field, but for magnetic field, this is del dot B is equal to 0. This is Ampere circuital law. This is Gauss law in magnetic field, and this equation is in electric field. So today we have done the Maxwell's equation. What are all the corrections to the Maxwell's equation in time varying field? We have listed in integral form as well as the point form, and we have done few numericals wherein which by giving the value of E we have calculated H, by giving the value of H we have calculated E, and by giving both the equations E and H we have just checked whether those two are satisfying Maxwell's equations or not, and we have also done the numerical to calculate the unknown variable k using the Maxwell's equation in time varying field. So these are the answers to the quiz question, and that's what I intend to cover today. So thank you all. Thank you very much.